I'm just gonna double check that the audio from the game is coming through this time. I've never actually played this game. I'm a huge Twin Peaks fan, so I know that it has a lot of basis in references to Twin Peaks by David Lynch, so that's pretty cool. I'm looking forward to perhaps recognizing some of them and either parsing them out to my knowledge and explaining what I know. I'm also on my phone, so apologies. I'm going to turn up the graphics in a moment as well. Because I am boring, I know, when I just sit here. That's okay. I'm not a world famous streamer. Okay. So let's see. I like subtitles, putting them on video commentary. I'm not really sure what that means, but I'm gonna keep it off. God ray quality. I don't know what this does. I don't know what setting is good, so I'm just gonna put it midway. But yeah, this is the settings that I have chosen. How difficult.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse.
For some urgent reason,
I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. Seen the hitchhiker too late.
Yikes.
He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone.
He's on some drugs.
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
All right. Look up to the light.
The radiator had broken when I hit the hitchhiker. The car wasn't going anywhere.
Look at all my porno tapes strewn out on the road. I'm so ashamed. Oh, it's his own book. Never mind.
I was certain I had just driven from this direction.
But
okay. Now the road was blocked. I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important
waiting for me
there.
Okay, Alan, I heard you the first time. I'm just exploring. Calm the fuck down. To be honest, this reminds me a lot more of Silent Hill so far than it does of Twin Peaks. I reached a checkpoint already. Oh my god, a tire. I lost my tire. That's serious damage. Hold on, I gotta use sweet. Adjusting my monitor. There we go. So the lighthouse is that. Ooh, beer. Oh, they're empty. This game looks pretty good, though. I'm gonna go this way and see what it... Oh, it's... Never mind. It's silent, it held off.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Pick up coffee thermos. Collectible coffee thermos. Never heard of that. What if I jump down? Oh my god, I don't want to die. That dude is missing. Have you seen this man? Call 555-07-810-381. That's a lot of numbers. Whoa, I don't... Creepy! What?
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God? You think you could just make up stuff?
You don't hit me, sir.
Play with people's lives and kill them when you think it adds to the drama?
Oh, is he a character, though?
You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer. You're a joke. It would be a single readable sentence in your books if it wasn't for your editor. Never publish another one.
That guy's not very nice. I don't like him. I wonder what scanning the QR code would do.
Like your story's already good.
I'm gonna try it. Hold on.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills and pretentious shit.
No one of them.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Wow, this guy just keeps talking shit while I'm just chilling here trying to scan a QR code. Oh, it's just the Facebook page for Alan Wake. Okay, whatever. Whoop-de-doo. Alright. Good to know. Better picture of this man. Oh, it's 87810. Just in case you want to help out. Okay, is that the guy's gone. Can I go back up? Apparently not. Press A to jump. Ah! That was a weird jump out. You know, memento. Pardon me, everybody. Letting my friend know I'm streaming. Alright. I will say, though, I do like the graphics. It does have an unease to it, so it's...
You missed your dick!
Go away! I don't want to dodge you.
Damn.
How do I dodge? Press LB and...
You can't stop me!
Can you just fuck off? Oh, okay. Highlighted, it was a cinematic.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
Duh. More items for me to pick up? No.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Thank you. are that it's more like the bad Silent Hill ending where
there was no way out.
Oh shit, how do I? Well, this is unnerving.
Beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light.
Follow my light. Oh, cool.
Your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
Is this your own voice? I don't get it. Is this his own voice?
The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now.
Thank you, Light
Daddy.
Oh my god.
The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Where's the flashlight?
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Like Sybil after you give her the Aglophis. She's no longer protected.
Good. Cool. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
On Earth? Okay. So this is definitely, he's dreaming his own novel. That's just my prediction, personally. Give me a moment. Do-do-do-do-do. Boosting the light with left trigger blinds the enemies and burns the darkness away faster. Okay, cool. So it's like a light gun, basically. Yeah, this looks pretty good. How do I switch to... Goodbye. I said no. Bacon's good for me. Oh. Alright. That was not advised.
This is it.
I don't like you. Go away. Scare me. God, I don't like him. Is he up? Ah, that scared the shit out of me. I'm out of batteries? Fuck. Help. I need help. Where is he? Get the fuck. Do you have batteries for me? Okay, well he's gone, so bye. Okay, the coffee thermos, yeah, okay. If we're talking about fish in the percolator, fair. Twin Peaks reference right there. Lucy. Laura Palmer was killed.
Just
and her body was found by a lighthouse. I have to kill three guys at once? Honestly, that was kind of like the Silent Hill film scene where when they're going to the church, the sirens, and that you can see the darkness approaching like a veil of rain almost.
You're dead just like me.
What? I thought I already had the flare gun. I don't like these guys. They scare the shit out of me. You die. Oh, I almost jumped off the edge. I almost died myself. I don't like
this up.
Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Okay. like, it looks like a logging town. Okay. There's a little restaurant. I see it. There's pine trees. Triple D's! Nice. Okay, yeah, I see some of the similarities in what they're saying here. Welcome to Bright Falls.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host
of like
the local
to have a
radio
threesome?
Station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Not to be presumptuous.
Mr. Main, I'm on vacation.
Oh, I see a
In
rifle.
Fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you
Smoked
have
Fish
a
Company.
Out.
Damn, I want some. Paint jobs, garbage, vicar, fresh seafood. Good. A water bottle. Okay, thanks, Bob.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend.
Shut
That's
up.
Cute.
Right.
Oh, I can't go out.
Yeah?
Hey, Ben Teller, how's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah, we just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great, great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Yeah, definitely the logging
Alan,
town vibe. I can
Come on, let's get back to the car.
I can see the Twin Peaks stuff.
Come on, slowpoke. You get the full service here.
I'm a slowpoke. Just give me 2 seconds.
I drive the car. I'll even carry the bags. All you have to do is drag your cute butt into the car and enjoy the ride.
Yeah, sounds like you've got a lazy bastard for a husband.
What?
Yeah, but
or
I
he's just got
him.
Mental illness.
Come on, you lazy bastard. Let's go.
We drive a Lincoln. You don't get to call me that. Where do I go? What do you want me to do? You said my lazy butt where? Oh, get back to the car. I'm dumb. I got it.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes.
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
Thank you. Oh, okay,
I've
yeah.
There
Sheriff.
Are still places
in
like this.
Okay,
towns
I need to take
everybody
a break.
Knew everybody.
Just for a bit.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could
diner.
Help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan.
You're definitely
I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't
Coffee and
believe
pie.
It. I've got all of your books.
All your books?
I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
Yeah, okay.
And you keep it here. Well,
I see
okay.
where people draw
Good
conclusions.
For you.
This guy in particular looks similar. Okay, I gotta take a break, y'all, so I'm just gonna pause the recording.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Yeah, that's
Rusty
definitely...
here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Definitely.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Coffee references. Okay, I'm gonna pause it. I hope it will pause for as long as I need. If
Are
not,
you staying
I'll restart
long, Mr.
later.
Wake?
See you soon.
I can't believe it.
a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
Ha! You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder you in your sleep.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring. Cauldron Lake is a special place, very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind Sarah to change...
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
She got some flashlights.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Uh-oh.
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago.
Ha
ha! I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years.
We're all has-beens.
This is my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
You know, I have my graphics on the full settings, and it's kind of... like, it's definitely an older game, that's all I can say.
Wow. It's gorgeous.
Driver's Isle.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey.
But we don't have the
I'll
cabin key.
I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
We won't be, because she forgot the key.
Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Hello? Anyone here?
The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
70s.
For a moment, the oppressive feel of
owl.
The nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Oh, that... I didn't like
Damn.
That. No, thank you. That was... no.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island.
But it was a secret... game of what? Divers. Interesting. Well, this game has my attention so far, I can say that. These aren't open. Isn't that where they would be? Like the fuse box, I mean? I suppose it could be like on the main floor.
The Deer Fest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. Famous artist, no less. We'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones, caller. You're on PBFF.
Aw, it won't let me jump into the ocean and just die. That sucks. What kind of game is this? I thought I... Focus.
The water was clear but dark. It looked very deep.
That's because it is. All right. Jump into the water.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
I know, I just saw, yeah, I just realized. Ooh, an axe, let's pick it. Well, let me pick it up. Excuse me, Shed. I need to enter.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
A bit.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that.
Why did it just get cut off by itself?
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Why did you end out over here?
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
Because it was evil.
Alice? Honey?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone keeps...
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan?
Just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Because I was emotionally stunted and I couldn't talk to my girlfriend. Loser.
Damn it. Alice?
Alice!
No, no!
Alice!
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right, I'm coming!
Alan! Help me!
What the hell?
No!
One nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
Wow, we've had like three separate intros. Can the game just pick one? It's a little disorienting.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice.
I didn't like it.
I didn't like it. And I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
I'm so confused. Did you... Anyways, this guy. I didn't like the fight with my wife.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
And it says Stuckey's. Can we just jump and be done with it? Seems rational. Right? Okay. Goodbye, car. Alright, well, let's go with it. Because I have nothing to live for. My car is gone. Alright, let us run and jump and run and jump. Totally normal. Ooh, an overlook. Let's look at the river. I hear owls hooting.
Hello?
There's gotta be a witch's cabin. Somewhere. Dropped my remote. Apologies to the audience of two, which I am grateful for. This game is
Hello?
Weird.
Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page,
You're
the hero
insane.
Was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Oh, great. So, you're living through your final book, I guess? And your book is taunting you? I mean, this doesn't remind me of either Silent Hill or Twin Peaks. No!
Please! I've been in an accident!
I don't want to fight this guy. He scares me. Alright, that's it. Swimming.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Well, it's literally right... You're going to have to... You're almost done hiking all the way there. What are you talking about?
Anybody there? Please! I've been in an accident!
Just Jesus. Can you not jump that? Alan.
Hey!
Oh, okay.
Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation.
Deposit required. Fair and square.
Buddy. Who are you talking to? Find help? What is happening? Sir, are you okay? I do need help. I need you.
Premium!
No, how many manuscript pages do I need to get the whole thing? Oh! So is that, let me guess, am I supposed to read that? And it tells me that I was going...
Departure by Alan Wake.
Are you fucking serious? I need to watch. Oh, I have four viewers now. Hi.
The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
All right, and the second or third page?
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Willing it to stop coming. Did you hear that, folks? What kind of blasphemy is that? Alright, so we went back down to 3 viewers. Sorry, I'm boring. Or I talk too much. I probably won't. Want to. I don't like him.
To arrive!
You lose!
Shit.
The deposit!
It's the latest thing! Great!
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door
this
with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
That's it. Fight him with a flashlight. Pick up batteries, you motherfucker. Those are definitely Energizer brand, too.
I wasn't about to open the door, as long as I was liable to catch an axe with my forehead.
How about catching ass?
The latest thing.
Okay, but aren't I supposed to open it and fight him?
Proven!
Bitch, can you just let me come inside and kick here? What about this gate? Close this. Put yourself in jail.
See the sights and keep those cholesterol levels.
Call for help. Oh, call for help. Okay. That's like Twin Peaks Season 3 reference, but
yes.
This wouldn't have been out before that.
Right, Paul Sheriff Station.
Hello?
Well, I'm gonna die. I can tell. Oh, I'm down 2 meters again.
This is bad.
Sweet. Got it. Trying to get away from this guy as fast as I can, and it's not fast, so I'm sorry. There's multiple? Oh my god, oh my god. Ah! Okay.
Fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Okay, I got a flare gun now. I like big batteries and I cannot lie. No other brother can deny. Reach the gas. Oh! Okay, I'm very silly for electrocuting myself, but let's see if I can heal myself with this light. Heal me. I'm looking at you. That wasn't helpful. I guess it's a temporary arrow for this, so it tells me to go here. And then this would tell me to go where? Above? Bitch, what? What was this? Yes, the good old electrician's trick.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
It's rabbit season.
I really don't like how good they are at making me scared. Oh, shit. Bye. It's red now. I like it. What's that there light? It's a manuscript page. And it says... Rose daydreams about...
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife.
He wrote
She was
this.
Pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
All right, let us figure out, ooh, that's pretty, what to do next. Do I have a map? Is there a map? No? Okay, fuck it. Let's get lost together, folks. Have to say, the flashbacks, they make them really loud and it's scary.
What the hell was that? When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head.
Just shut up.
I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
You're alive. You're fine. Wanna go on this one and do gymnastic high beam. See how good I am, Oh my god. What is that? That's part of the tree. Aha, I knew there would be something out here. The fuck is wrong? Oh. I almost ran into the river. What's wrong with these logs? Do I have to push this over? No. Go this way. Yes. I want to reach the gas station. Oh yes, I do. What's this manuscript page say? Barry's arrival.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. Hmm. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that. Not sleeping. Messed
okay.
up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
His best friend was in trouble and he wouldn't let it happen. Let us continue the... Oh, that's the cat. Or the house, or whatever you want to call it. Do I keep going this way or another way? Let's find out. I think it's this way. I don't like you.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Not a fan. Fuck you. Alan, you can't jump a little rock? Come on, buddy. Be better than that. Doing some exploring of the land, you see? I gotta know where I'm at.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
You're telling me that you, as a grown man, can't jump up that? I could find a way to climb that. Good old Energizer batteries, thank you. Oh.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
It looks like there's one literally right here. Is that not a generator? Oh, I see a mug.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Yeah. Are you serious? You're gonna let them come back here, but you're not gonna let them pass that.
I couldn't stay here. There had to be a way to get up there.
I understand. I'm looking. I thought that thing was a generator.
They're taken. Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Can they fill me with something else? Kind of pitiful that little jump would hurt him, but okay. Just my thought on the matter. There's more arrows here, so does it want me to go? Or it's probably just to the other arrow, okay. Where's the actual generator, folks? I gotta be. There it is. I forgot how to... It won't let me... Okay, that wasn't fun. It would... Okay, we're just gonna restart that, pretend like that didn't happen. Oh, I have to do it again because I died and I lost my items like a silly person.
Taken. They're taken. With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top. Yuri hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
And now I shall fight them. Pitiful. One hit? Damn it. Alright, so I'm gonna try to just be very defensive in that regard. Which direction is this way? Ooh, I have two viewers again. Hello, hello. I think I just confused. Yeah, this way.
Taken. They're taken. Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Okay, wish me luck this time.
Nice.
I thought I... God damn it. I really tried. I tried. Alright. Please don't leave me. I'm gonna get batteries once more. Just 1 second, folks. I gotta plug my one phone. Sorry about that.
Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Did it this time. Might have wasted a teeny bit of ammo, but that's okay. Where's your hard hat?
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top. I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
All right, buddy has some sad dreams. Find this page in nightmare difficulty mode. Okay. Or not, because I don't want to be scared any more than I am.
I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep.
Take a huff of those poppers and lie back.
The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. Do listeners know I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could. Looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on here.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
And then his wife's gonna be dead because he killed her, just like in Silent Hill 2.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the state. Belly Burster is the best with no cut. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
Oh, I'm not a fan. Oh, I have to fight them. I don't like this.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
semblance.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
It to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Quantum Suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol.
I'm gonna shoot
myself. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment. Known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing...
Raise your hard hat. Try this again.
Cool!
Oh, caught that one.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reached the lights at the gas station alive.
Oh no. I see a deer. I see a sign for gasoline.
I recognize the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
Until I was stabbed. That's a big Rudolph for a big reindeer. 68th annual deer something. Deer fest.
The deer fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
You killed your wife. I just know it. It just would not surprise me. Pardon me. Ooh, I heard a growl.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Am I gonna have to turn on this TV too? Oh, right. For fuck's sake.
I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix her. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
Great Ball Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
You killed him.
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Was here a minute ago. Oh, wow.
A candy-colored clown they call the Sandman tiptoes to my room every night, and just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes.
This literal song is in the third season of Twin Peaks, so now I don't know if the third season of Twin Peaks is referencing Alan Wake or if it's a coincidence. But David Lynch is a master. So I don't want to skip yet, but I like this song.
Then I fall asleep to dream my dreams of you. In dreams I walk with you. In dreams I talk.
I'm letting you listen to the song
to you.
It's a good song.
Previously on Alan Wake. I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice!
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
What you're saying is that you...
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
Honey! I'm home.
Back here, sweetie.
Wait.
How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
Oh man, this would be a nice apartment to live in. Look at this. Yeah, I like this.
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan! Alan, please check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please hurry.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
Oh, they have a balcony too.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wick, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then.
There's just a
Sarah,
fish.
Sheriff Breaker is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Doc Nelson was the image of a small town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
So that guy's supposed to be like the doc, like the, not the psychiatrist, but the... Is it,
Thank you for testing the lights.
Oh,
Ms.
no,
Weaver.
I can't think of...
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged
now. I can't think of her name. Donna's parents. Donna's dad.
Doc. I'll be sure to take care of it, Ms. Weaver. Have a nice day now.
Dad.
Very good.
But I'll come back later on to remind you, just in case.
Yeah, it's, Mulligan here. I'm at Stuckey's gas station with Thornton. There's no sign of him. Over.
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the brake float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stuckey was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsal today. Over.
Oh, give me that. Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay, roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stuckey. Jane's out.
I wonder where Stuckey went. Maybe he killed him. Pardon me, I'm just looking.
Mr. Wake, the sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor.
Hmm. feel like those have got to be the makers of the game or something.
Your phone, Mr. Wake?
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake?
How did you end up at Stucky's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me. I need to take this. Hello?
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're gonna meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal. We're watching you.
Mr. Wake, can I help you with anything?
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor. Just don't mind Walter in there. He's one of our regulars.
Hey, mister! Hey, can you turn the light? The light's on! The deputies, they don't understand. They won't... Thank you, man, thank you. Hey, you're all right. You're a good guy. Don't let anybody tell you different.
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
Well, folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for me to sign off for a while. God knows I need my beauty sleep. Just one more item before I go. It's been a busy night for the sheriff's department. We've had a few broken windows, even a report of shots fired on Main Street. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton had to deal with two intoxicated young men who were celebrating the completion of their Deer Fest float. Now,
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The caller meant business.
Barry?
You for a week, you and Alice. Oh, I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Al, what the hell is going on?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness.
Marvelous, Sarah. I just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused.
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh! Hey! Oh, my!
Take it easy.
Wow.
Hey, nobody move. Get your hands off of my client.
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money. And he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Mr. Wake! Barry, you found him!
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later!
Who's Max?
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. takes a swing at everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you. And she was very helpful when I was looking for you. Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car? Just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy? And his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? Are you high? Have you been drinking? Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong, it's a good story, could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality,
you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure.
Seriously, Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
Wait here.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too. If you have any trouble finding it, just keep your eyes on the radio mast. It's right below that. Oh, and hey, if you take a walk in the woods, watch your step so you don't end up like Max. I guess I'm a little worried. We got a bunch of campers out there we haven't heard from. It's not like these people are on a schedule, but with the traps, well, you know, I just don't want any trouble.
Right, thanks.
If you're trying to pull a joke on me,
freak me out, it's working. Ha ha, let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now. Look, Al, you're asking me to believe that you shot a dude.
Crazy talk, Al. Al? Al?
We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry. They'll kill her.
This is not a goddamn debate, Barry.
Who's she?
I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay then. I understand. You're my best friend and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
Achoo!
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous.
Yokels?
Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
Achoo!
Bless
you.
Oh, this place is trying to kill me. I'll bet there's mold in here, spores, poison ivy, God knows what. This is so not worth a 15% commission.
wait here, Al. I'll hold down the fort. I'll be with you in spirit every step of the way, Al. Locking the door now.
Barry had the keys to the car he rented. Wasn't a long walk to the visitor center, and it wouldn't be any use to me in the forest. I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc, what's your Deerfest plan like?
My plan? You'll make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage.
Well, that scared me a little bit.
Crime and punishment. The cancer and cure.
His office was locked. I'd need a key to get in.
Hello?
Back here. I'm back here. Hey, please help me.
Mr. Wake?
Oh, hell.
It happened just the way it was on that page. I found. Came true. It knew. so dark. It'll come back for me. You must... The lights. In the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back.
Whatever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened. The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on. Too late. Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back on.
Rusty! Rusty!
The ground was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness. Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the wall.
Please!
Don't feed the animals!
Fishing
is only permitted
for those fishers who purchase a park
fishing
license, obey!
Instructions.
At all times. Rusty?
Rusty, no! Never!
No closer than 100 yards!
Two bears and wolves! Never approach any other
wildlife
closer than
25 yards.
Pets must be leashed
at all times.
Never leave your
pet unattended.
It is
against the law
to remove any
natural objects
or historical artifacts from the park.
Rums.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
Not even for Jesus.
Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
I got killed. All right.